ഇടാം നാം യേശുവിനായി സാക്ഷികളായിടാം.
A reading from the book of Esther, chapter 16. The following is a copy for this letter. The great king Ahasuerus to the governors of the provinces from India to Ethiopia, 127 provinces, and to those who are loyal to our government, greetings. Many people, the more they are honored with the most generous kindness of their benefactors, the more proud do they become, and not only seek to injure our subject, but in their inabilities to stand prosperity, they even undertake to scheme against their own benefactors. They not only take away thankfulness from others, but carried away by the boast of those who know nothing of goodness, they even assume that they will escape the evil-hating justice of God, who always sees everything. And often, many of those who are set in places of authority have been made in part responsible for the shedding of innocent blood and have been involved in immediate calamities by the persuasion of friends who have been entrusted with the administration of public affairs. When these persons, by the false trickery of their evil natures, beguile the sincere goodwill of their sovereigners. What has been wickedly accomplished through the pestilent behavior of those who can exercise authority unworthily can be seen not so much from the more ancient records that we hand on as from investigation of matters close at hand. In the future, we will take care to redeem our kingdom quiet and peaceful for all. By changing our methods and always by judging what comes before our eyes with more equitable consideration. For Haman, son of Hammedatha, and Machudo, and quite devout to our kindliness, have become our guests, enjoyed so fully the goodwill that we have for every nation, that he was called our father and was continually bowed down to by all the persons second to the royal throne. But unable to restrain his arrogance, he undertook to deprive us of our kingdom and our life. And with the intricate craft and design, asked for the destruction of Mordecai, our savior and perpetual benefactor, and of Esther, the blameless partner of our kingdom. Together with their whole nation, he thought that by this method, he would catch us undefended and would transfer the kingdom of the Persians to the Macedonians. But we find that the Jews who were consigned to annihilation by this thrice accursed man are not evildoers, but are governed by most righteous laws and are children of the living God, most high, most mighty, who has directed the kingdom both for us and for our ancestors in the most excellent order. You will therefore do well not to put in execution the letters sent by Haman, son of Hammedatha, since he, the one who did these things, has been hanged at the gate of Susa with all his household. For God, who rules over all things, has speedily inflicted on him the punishment that he deserved. Therefore, post a copy of this letter publicly in every place and permit the Jews to live under their own laws. And give them reinforcements so that on the 13th day of the 12th month, Adar, on that very day, they may defend themselves against those who attack them at the time of oppression. For God, who rules over all things, has made this day to be a joy for his chosen people instead of a day of destruction for them. Therefore, you shall observe with all good cheer as notable day among your commemorative festivals, so that both now and hereafter it may represent deliverance for you and the royal Persians, but that it may be a reminder of destruction for those who plot against us. Every city and country, without exception, that does not act accordingly shall be destroyed in wrath, with spear and fire. It shall be made not only impassable for human beings, but also most hateful to wild animals and birds of all time.